with an anthem from one of my favorite composers, Herbert Howells. You might be familiar with some of his shorter works, like this anthem. He has a fantastic Requiem setting that is very beautiful. And my very favorite work actually was written after the death of JFK. It's called Take Him Earth for Cherishing. So go and YouTube that. It's truly sublime. But this one, like as the heart, it's as the deer pants for the streams of water. You'll have some questions asked in this anthem. And what I want to draw your attention to, where is now thy God? And it goes on. And as the psalmist often writes, there's deep soul searching and a great sense of despair. But it's not all gloomy. The arc of the second half of the program, you'll find some answers at the end if you're searching, like the psalmist. You'll find the answers at the end of the concert. But also, what's nice about this is that the last piece on the program also serves as a good bookend because of the influence of jazz in these two pieces. So Herbert Howells very much inherited the Victorian style of composition, but then infused it with these wonderfully colorful, jazzy moments. So you'll hear that in the organ part especially, right from the very beginning. So this is Like as the Heart.
I didn't have a PhD.
to an extended work by Britten, and I've already alluded to some things that connect this to other portions of the program. But it's the quirkiness about the text of this piece that I want to draw your attention to, and I believe you have the text in your program. So you may choose to ignore that and just listen, but you will find some rather unusual elements to this text if you follow along in particular. And the text is written by a poet from the 19th century named Christopher Smart. He was writing in this work, Ugolati Agno, he was writing a rather ecstatic and devotional kind of poetry. And he himself was actually incarcerated. He was put in an asylum. And it's believed that he was probably jailed for his particularly charismatic display of his faith. And so here we have an example of a prisoner of conscience. And the other reasons why he was seen to have been an outsider are not totally known. But the writing here is in the style of the Psalms. So in some places you'll see a sort of call and response that might be familiar in other poetic writings from the Bible. But also an interesting parade of animals that you don't usually read about. Yeah? And names all drawn from the Old Testament, except for the name of Christ himself. But these other names are Old Testament names, and they're paired up with a different animal. Most of them make sense if you know the story from the Bible and the biblical account of these particular characters. But Nimrod and Ithamar and all sorts of fun people. So the opening is quite playful, which is in keeping with Britten's sort of interesting musical style. He liked these sorts of fun changes of meter and things like that, sudden changes of dynamic and so forth. But it's later in the text that I think we really find a very poignant moment, and it's where the poet is talking about the watchman smiting him and the officers of the peace looking over him. And again, it connects with the many writings from the Psalms, like the one we just heard from Psalm 42. And so we have this sort of searching, this soul searching, and this questioning of why is this happening to me? And yet we have on the sort of as almost bookends of this work a setting of hallelujah. So there's this sort of return to a remarkable stillness, which is what I titled the program, and a deep sense of faith that I think really does sort of run through all of this text. So it will proceed without any particular breaks, and will feature four of our wonderful young soloists. And so I invite you to follow along with the text from time to time if you find that helpful, and hope you enjoy Rejoice in the Lamb.
Thank you. Let David bless with the well, and the life.
Sopranos and tenors will be paired in octaves, and altos and basses will be paired in octaves. But you'll hear what I mean when I say sort of an interesting harmonic language. And then that will be followed by a piece, I think this is the most recent of compositions on the program. This is by Will Todd, and this is The Call of Wisdom. Here's where we get answers to the psalmist questions from Psalm 42. That we heard in the Howells piece. And this also is influenced by jazz very much. Will Todd is a jazz pianist, but very beautiful choral pieces. And so we conclude with John Tavener and Will Todd. Thank you so much for inviting us to be here, Lucy, tonight. It's such a pleasure, and hope it's not the last time. So we begin with the Lamb.